yesterday's meeting. This is a conflict began 5 months ago. Bringing up a patent time worker to stop the war. It has resulted into the murder of hundreds of innocent civilians. UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon has confirmed that both the President Salva Kiir and the Italian official have been assured that they will attend the meeting to the war in Ethiopia. Over the past few days, South Sudanese government troops have been trying in vain to capture the town of Bentiu from the rebels. The US government has imposed sanctions targeting some key military commanders from both sides, who, according to the Secretary of State there, John Kerry, were responsible for perpetrating a total of violence in Bentiu, resulting in the death of over 200 civilians. Some reports have suggested that the rebels have fallen to considering the weapons they are currently using. The EPDF remains in war and meets demands by the international community that they be withdrawn. Yesterday, President Museveni was speaking in London, saying no foreign power can cover him. But who will open the country as this will jeopardize the gains made. The conflict in South Sudan remains a threat to both the political and economic stability of this country. United Nations has indicated that President Kong and some of his most resistant army commanders are hiding in South Sudan near the border of the Central African Republic. So tonight we speak from a look at the dynamics of this country and the possibility of a future of lasting peace should be face to face meeting between the two countries. Former Director General of the External Security Organization, a member of the African Security Network, also a regional defense and security office, and also can have a meeting.
Thank you, and good evening, listeners.
I'm really good to have you here. We also expect to join the Honourable Senator of the Women West in the Member of the Defense and the General Affairs Committee of Parliament, and also an expert on defense and security.
Drivers are really basically political maneuvering, if you like. It's akin to, similar to what we're going through in a lesser way, though, between President Museveni and one particular member, that's Secretary General. So there was a Secretary General called Paganamu. There is a president called Kim, and there is election coming in 2015, and then the Vice President Machar, and all the position, the posturing, the Kabaran, and so forth, all those who want to contest within the party, the ruling party, SPLM, have a time to contest the coming elections, who are not satisfied with the performance of Kim, and therefore posturing and demanding for here in Uganda, we're asking for electoral reforms. There, they wanted more political reforms. And they claimed that there was no constitution. So, implementing CPA, it's a couple of years, we're for 9 years now, two of which in independent South Sudan, the rest was in the CPA. Now, in the first 9 years, without a national constitution, we finished 9 years without a national army which is professional, an army which is still divided on tribal lines. We finished 9 years, okay, with all these problems. So there are those who thought that it was important to change the leadership of the country and therefore take the country to a better destination. And then there are those who want to hold on to it. Of time, okay? Just similar circumstances we are here. One of that, our players here are a bit more sophisticated and I think have the country more. So I'm not yet up, I hope, to the key Machar School of Righteousness. That I mean, Namama and Museveni. I mean, the way they are going about their team, every player, I think they're careful enough not to make things worse. But it's a similar situation which developed in South Sudan. And fearless in hand.
Thank you.
offer to me that party discussion of social studies should go to deployment for the forces immediately. The peace and force appeal, if you like, an implication force, so that the standing the standing between the two groups, so that this war does not spread into war, so that this war does not go back into the doing more damage within the United communities and so forth. So they need to fight that. And also we need to test the commitment of these particular two leaders, those are real committed social hostilities. So for this meeting of tomorrow to work, unless and until those regional forces, and I think America is saying they should be UN.
Excuse me, I'm trying to confirm it, but otherwise there's a regular human body type. Otherwise, you get it.
pouco, qualquer visão, qualquer visão, mas por exemplo, você não é um pouquinho do que é
Thank you.
the point I'm making here. So yes, we appreciate the role you put in this play, but what we don't appreciate about you put here, by the time we use a major and some oversight in our hands, what can we do about that? So please, take our losses, bring our boys back. And at least we should find out our brother. I know you can't do anything for our brother. But at least, look out here.
And I'm saying,